following program will cover information about how to properly wear PT gear and how to conduct proper fitness form while exercising.
The mask will cover both the nose and mouth. The following solid colors are authorized per the U.S. Air Force: white, black, coyote brown, tan, sage green, and olive green. The following camouflages are also authorized: airman battle uniform pattern and operational camouflage pattern. Masks will be worn at all times when a distance of 10 feet between each cadet is not possible in physical training, 6 feet in any other circumstance outside of PT. Female cadets must not wear any earrings during physical training. Wearing necklaces and rings are unauthorized for all cadets during PT, unless it is a wedding band. Male cadets may not polish their nails. However, for female cadets, nail polish and acrylic nails must be a natural color, no more than 1/4 inches in length from the fingertip, and must be well groomed. The only jewelry to be worn by cadets that is authorized during physical training is as follows: sports watches, prisoner of war, missing in action bracelets, and medical bracelets. Female cadets must have their hair up in at least a ponytail. Any other hairstyles besides hair fully down is authorized. Flyaways are acceptable in physical training, but not leadership laboratory. Hair ties and hair clips worn must be either blonde, brown, or black in color. Male cadets must be clean shaven at all training events and anywhere else in uniform unless a cadet has a shaving waiver for medical reasons. With the shaving waiver, facial hair will be neatly trimmed and no more than 1/4 inch in length. This standard still applies when wearing a face covering due to the COVID-19 pandemic. All cadets who wear glasses must have a black or blue eyeglass strap that connects at the back of the head. The following colors are authorized for cadet frames: black, brown, silver, and gold. Male cadets will maintain hair that is 1/4 inches or shorter on the sides. In addition, the hair will have a tapered appearance, meaning no sharp lines or fad hairstyles. No hair will touch the ears. Sideburns cannot extend past the lower opening of the ear. Hair on the scalp must be no more than 1 1/4 inches in bulk. Mustaches are authorized, however, they must not extend beyond the corners of the cadet's lips. All cadets will wear PT shirts and PT shorts. PT shirts must be neatly tucked in, wrinkle-free, and stain-free at all times. PT shorts will also be wrinkle and stain-free. Undergarments such as spandex, underwear, and leggings must be conservative in nature and either solid dark blue or black in color. Waistband strings will be tucked in. Sloppy or incomplete shirt tucks are unauthorized. Shoes can be any color in nature, as it is important to wear a pair of comfortable athletic shoes. However, they must have shoelaces. They can either be tucked into the shoes or untucked. It is unwise to wear sneakers above the ankle. Although they provide ankle stabilization, they tend to lead to shin splints. Both solid black or solid white socks are authorized when in physical training. Socks cannot extend past the cadet's mid-calf. If the socks have logos, they must be small in size.
When conducting proper push-up form, shoulder blades must be level and parallel to the ground. As it is time to assume the up position, arms will be fully extended, but elbows will not be locked.
An indication of proper form in the down position is when elbows are at 90 degrees. You may go lower than 90 degrees, but you need to be at least at 90 degrees.
Again, 90 degrees will be maintained, and the spine will be completely straight throughout the entire push-up repetition.
Place your palms and fists on the floor, slightly wider than shoulder width apart. Your elbows will be extended. Your feet may be no further than 12 inches apart and should not be supported, raised, or crossed.
This is what improper form looks like. When conducting proper sit-up form, feet must be restrained by some form of toe bar, with knees remaining at 90 degrees. No more, no less. Elbows will touch the thighs every repetition. For proper sit-up form, you may only rest in the up position. Your behind must stay grounded. Fingertips must rest on the collarbone, and shoulder blades will touch the ground every repetition. This is what improper form looks like.
Form running teaches you to land underneath yourself, which allows you to run lighter, easier, and smoother. There are three simple points to good form running. Posture is all about getting your body into better alignment so it can move efficiently. You should keep compact, relaxed arms, your knees bent, and your body tall. Landing is about how and where you make contact with the ground. You should land on your midfoot, underneath your center of mass, and avoid overstriding by taking quick, light steps which allow you to glide across the ground instead of pounding. Forward lean allows you to utilize gravity instead of work against it. You should lean from the ankles, do not bend from the hips, and remember, although the lean is very subtle, it is very important. The three points to good form running are posture, landing, and lean, and will allow you to run faster, easier, and healthier.